Hello friends, welcome to Insight Techs. This is the platform to learn about power transmission elements and its control systems. In today's video, we are going to learn about very special equipment, that is a current transformer. So what is a current transformer? Current transformer is used for the measurement of current and protection of power system. What it does is it transforms current from one winding to another. And it comes in various ratios like 100 ampere to 1 ampere, 300 ampere to 1 ampere, 600 amperes to 1 ampere and so on. Which means that when the primary current is 100 ampere, we will get 1 ampere in the secondary side. Now let's see various types of current transformers. The first one is the epoxy CT, then we have oil filled CT, which can be further categorized as live tank CT and dead tank CT, and finally the optical CT. Let's understand what is epoxy CT. So this type is generally used for 11 kV and below, and this type of CT is normally used where we have indoor bus. This CT looks as seen in the image, and you can see its primary and secondary terminals very clearly. We have oil filled CT. This kind of CT are normally used for above 11 kV voltage levels. So this is the example of live tank, as you can see. Then there is a dead tank CT as shown over here. So now let us understand few basic things about dead tank type of CT and live tank type of CT. For dead tank type of CT, as we can see over here, there is a primary conductor that comes from top to this bottom section, and again from the bottom section it goes to the top section. And what happens is, when it comes down at the bottom section, there is a core situated at the bottom, and from that we get the secondary winding terminals. Now what happens in this live tank type of CT is, the primary conductor remains in the top portion itself, it does not go down. Also the secondary core is inside this upper side of the tank only. So only secondary wires come to the bottom section of this terminal box. Now due to this, the live tank type of CT has few disadvantages, like it is difficult while installation, and also in dead tank CT, weight of the secondary core is freely resting on the supports, while in the live tank the weight of the core is on the insulations. In the dead tank type of CT, the heat from the secondary winding is dissipated through the oil that is filled in the filled inside, while in the live tank heat is dissipated through the main insulations, which lowers the age of the insulation. So because of all these disadvantages, nowadays the dead tank type of CT are widely used. CT is the optical CT. This type of CT are alternative to conventional type of oil filled CT. Optical CT works on the Faraday's law and uses optical sensing methods to measure the electric current. What's the construction of a CT? We will consider a dead tank oil filled CT because that is widely used in the substations these days. So the first component is a bellow cover. Below that is a rubber bellow or steel bellow. The rubber bellow is the indication of some kind of dissolved gases present inside the CT, because whenever there is any fault and the arc is quenched inside within the oil, then the rubber bellow gives the indication that there might be some dissolved gases present inside the CT. Next is a primary contact or a primary stud. Then a porcelain insulator. There is internal primary path that can be called as the primary winding. Then there is a CT outside metal body. Then there is a CT core. And internal secondary current path or secondary winding. Then there is a 10 delta point, using which we can conduct a 10 delta test on the CT. Flows inside the CT, or how the current transformation actually happens. So what happens basically is when CT is connected in the circuit or online, its primary winding carries the line current, that is assuming 300 ampere. Generally, primary winding of a CT is made to pass through a core called as CT core, that is on the bottom part, and the winding over the core is called as the secondary winding. This winding gives the desired output amperes. So that is how we get 300 ampere, how we convert 300 amperes into 1 ampere using a CT. The CT terminal box. So what's inside a CT terminal box? As you can see, there are few outlets. Okay, let us understand each one in detail. These are called as CT secondary terminals, then the CT 10 delta point and CT earth point. Okay, this is a space for the cables to enter inside the CT terminal box. Okay, so now let us understand the electrical diagram of a current transformer. Shown over here is the electrical diagram of a current transformer. Now the P represents a primary winding and S represents the secondary winding. As you can see over here, the secondary winding is having three cores. This is core 1, this is core 2, and this is core 3. Each individual core now has three tappings, 1, 2, and 3. So how do you understand 1S1 is? 1 represents the core and this 1 represents its tapping. So 1S1 means it is the first tapping of a first core. 1S2 means it is the second tapping of the first core. And 1S3 means it is the third tapping of core 1. Similarly, it can be understood for core number 2 and core number 3 as well. So this is the terminal box diagram that we have seen in the earlier, and you can now relate all the secondary terminals with these terminals of the electrical diagram. Let us now talk about the accuracy of this core. So there is a class of accuracy for each core of the secondary winding. So the first core has accuracy of 0.5%, which means there can be a probability of 0.5% error. Second core is a 5P10 core, that means whenever the CT is carrying a current up to 10 times of its capacity, then there can be a probability of 5% error. And the last one is the PS type, that is a special protection core, in which the probability for the error is very minimum. So over here we can now see a table for all the three cores of the secondary winding representing its various class of accuracy. So that's it for today's video, guys. In the next video, we will continue with the wiring of CTMK box. Do watch the next video. Thank you.